What a day!
It's not the will of the people, and this country is supposed to run off of the will of the people!
In a landmark ruling, the Supreme Court today legalized abortions.
We're really scared of it derailing the progress that we're seeing in other parts of the world.
Doctors, they need to protect life. They should not be sacrificing life.
This bill will include a range of critical provisions to ensure the health and dignity of all girls and women.
We've also seen law reform more recently in Rwanda, Benin, Burkina Faso. Movements at the moment advocating for law reform in Zimbabwe, in Malawi, to mention a couple.
There is an increased energy and engagement by anti-choice organizations in trying to promote their agenda in these domestic health, you know, public health and reproductive rights movements.
My body, abortion on demand.
You know, if women can't access that service safely or legally, she will often go to desperate measures to terminate a pregnancy that she does not want to continue with. And, you know, this poses a threat to her life, her health, and you know, and obviously has a massive impact on her family and her community.
So abortion for me as a Christian is a no-go zone. When we put it for medical reasons, that term can be abused a lot. Whether the baby is out of defilement, whether the baby is out of incest, we should let the baby grow because the baby is very innocent.
I'm really optimistic that what we are going to see in the U.S. In the long term is going to be positive reform and actually maybe even a stronger legal framework than we have in Roe versus Wade, where we can really think about international human rights and we can see an abortion framework that's grounded in equality and not just privacy.